No school?
I think I know what I'm gonna do.
Hello world, hear the song that we're singing. Come on, get happy. A whole lot of loving is what we'll be bringing. We'll make you happy.
We have a dream, we go traveling together.
Good morning and welcome to the weekly morning news show. I'm Lena, and these shows are meant to give us something close to what we used to have in the studio. So let's get started. So a group of teachers decided to go around and wish all the seniors whose birthday is during quarantine a happy birthday. So here's Molly's video showing that.
Grill brand on the market today. Okay? Get your grills. Get ready for slime. This video is not sponsored by Weber. But get your grills. Come on, E-Slime. Welcome to your day two weather. Today there will be a high of something. Today there will be a high of 53 and a low of 39. It's a little chilly. Should a little chilly tonight, maybe. Wind's supposed to start kicking up, if it's not already obvious. We got gusts of about 20 miles per hour today. Let's see how everyone's doing during their quarantine.
Sir, if you could just answer one question for me, how is your quarantine going? How are you enjoying this weather today?
Birds chirping, feeling good.
Very good. Thank you.
Now for all you lovers of The Office, Liz made a video recreating the scene from The Office where Dwight makes a toilet paper device that deflies rolls of toilet paper to make them last longer.
Why'd you get the thinnest toilet paper possible?
Oh, what's that?
Oh yeah, I didn't do that.
Then who did?
Maybe it was like Dwight? Dwight? Who's Dwight? It's like to conserve toilet paper.
Have you come up with a creative way to conserve toilet paper? In addition to getting ready to play basketball next year in college, Sophie is also finding time to document her daily life. So here's a video of her making a smoothie bowl with her sister.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And glove box.
Glove box. Oh yeah. A full tank of gas.
My mom.
A backseat. My last car. Oh, and
a Mini Cooper notebook. So she can keep track of her thoughts as she's driving.
While I'm driving.
Content. Fifth gear. That's third. Back to fourth.
That's second. I'm just going down the list, aren't I?
Alright, there's fourth. Go. Gas it. Give it. Okay, we're gonna stop with the stoplight.
Jesus.
Are you sure you don't want me to drive?
Yes, I'm positive.
I think I want me to drive.
No.
Sometimes the best things in life are simple things. Senior Gabby Villa sent 5 ways to pass time during quarantine, and David shares his experience with a new puzzle he found from the 70s.
What's up? Welcome to a quick review of this puzzle I found in my attic. It's of Portofino, Italy. According to my mom, it was made in the early 70s, so I'm interested to find out how it stacks up to modern puzzles, and I'll get back to you once this is finished.
Yay, I finished the puzzle. Woohoo, let's go.
All right, the conclusion to my puzzle saga. I spent about 8 hours last night, up until 4 a.m., trying to finish this godforsaken puzzle, and with the help of 4 cups of coffee, I got to 1 piece left, at which point I fell asleep on my hardwood floor and woke up this morning to finally put the last piece in. So, overall, I would rate the puzzle a solid 7 out of 10, and I'm excited to see where my puzzle saga comes from here. So, thank you for joining us, and peace out.
Check in next Friday to see the weekly morning show. Next week will be produced by the Day One Morning Show.
Come on, get happy.
Peace.